In this video, we will demonstrate the new functionality of the tester for diagnosis power steering units, the MS561 PRO, using various units as examples. We have steering racks from Renault, Ford, Audi, and Porsche. Right now, we are connecting the rack from the Renault Espace. We need to find the rack in the software. Let's select it. We enter and see the connection diagram. We will connect using the universal cable included with the device. First, we connect it to the diagnostic tester and turn it on. We connect the cables to the connector as shown in the image. We need small cables here, so we connect those. Done. The rack is connected, and we can see how it operates. This rack has already been refurbished, and we are preparing it for sale. Using the tester, we will reset the VIN so that the new owner can install it more easily later. All set. The rack is ready for sale. Now, we will connect another rack from the Ford Focus. We find it in the database and check the connections. We connect the other cables because we need clamps here. We verify the rack and ensure everything is connected correctly, that it is functioning. Everything looks good. The new functionality allows us to read the original module number and other data about the unit. Next, there is a live data tab. Here we can view voltage, temperature, mileage, and other information. Additionally, in the next tab, we can read error codes. This eliminates the need for a separate scanner, as we did before. Here, we see three error codes. They are not significant and do not affect the operation of the rack. Next, in the tabs, there is a programming section. Here, we can reprogram the rack. We can choose firmware from those offered by the program or upload from a separate file. We will use the built-in options. First, second, third. There is also an additional firmware recovery function that allows us to roll back to a previous version if the module was programmed incorrectly. Now we press start and initiate the firmware update. We can see the process underway. All done. Now we restart the rack to ensure the firmware has been applied correctly. Everything is functioning well. Now let's flash the memory. Turn off the engine, go to the special functions, read the information to save the original file. We will make a backup and save the firmware that we have now. done. Write a new file. Check the operation of the rack. Everything is fine. Next, we will work with Audi rack. For this, we will need the FlexRay cable. We remove the universal cable and take out the FlexRay module. We connect it to the tester and the rack. We locate the rack in the program and switch to the FlexRay tab. We start it. We check the connections and confirm that it is operational. The functionality here also allows everything we demonstrated earlier: reading data, checking live data, and viewing error codes. There are also error codes present here, but they are not relevant and do not hinder operation. In the programming section, we will reprogram the rack. There are options for firmware or uploading your own file. To simply update the existing firmware, we check in another section to see which firmware is currently in use and select it. We launch it. It will take a little time to load. Successfully installed. We restart it to check how everything works. Now we disconnect it. Next, we will connect the rack from the Porsche Macan. We check how it operates. The functionality here is also fully available. Data, live data, and error code reading. We go to the programming section. Here is our firmware. We initiate the firmware update. Loaded. We check the operation of the rack. Everything is fine. So, the new functionality of the MS561 Pro tester has great potential for work and significantly simplifies the process. We are constantly working on improvements and adding new units. Thus, the tester is capable of diagnosing racks from. The program has many different languages, including Arabic.